Since you all have the papers in front of you, we may look at them and we all together decide this metta result. May all beings be happy and secure. May all beings have happy minds. Whatever it means that may be, without exception, weak or strong, long, large, medium, short, subtle or gross, visible or invisible, living here or far, born or coming to birth, may all beings have happy minds. Let no one deceive another, nor despise anyone anywhere, neither from anger nor ill will, should anyone wish harm to another. As the mother who restores her life to the protector of the child, even so towards all living beings, one should cultivate a heart of sorrow. One should cultivate for all the world a heart of boundless loving kindness, above, below, and all around, unobstructed, without hatred or resentment, understanding or almost sitting, lying down or in a way. One should develop this mindfulness. This is called the mind of the yoga. Not only to the wrong use, but virtuous and dark vision, removing desire for sensual pleasures. One comes never again to the earth in the moon. Now for meditation, we don't need light, we may turn off the light. Somebody who's at the back can turn off the light. Okay, with this metta thought in mind, let us begin our practice. I repeat these instructions every time we meditate, because I believe when you want to get water from the ground, you have to dig one place, maybe 100 feet. If you dig 10 holes, 10 feet each, you can fulfill the logical requirement, but you don't get water. Similarly, if you do the same thing again and again and again, as Buddha has repeatedly mentioned in his discourses, that we will make deep impression in our mind. And that is how it's going to work with meditation. And therefore these instructions I repeat every time we meditate. So we sit comfortably in reasonably comfortable posture. Keep your hands on your lap. Make your body straight, upright, so that you can breathe lung full of breath. And then focus your mind on your breathing. As you know, our mind is like a wild calf, a wild animal. Over the past many years, our mind has got information through our eyes, ears, nose, tongue, body and mind. They are stored in our mind. And therefore the mind is wandering here and there. In order to keep it in one place, we use our breath and focus it on the nostrils or tip of the nose or upper lip. This variation depends on the formation of nose. When you breathe several times, you can notice where the breath touches, and that is where you focus your mind. It is just like sinking a firm pole into the ground deep and tying the wild animal to the post. Then the animal will run around, trying to roam as before, but it cannot go beyond the length of the rope. So eventually it will go round and round and round. Finally he will stop running. Being tired, he may lie down. Similarly, this wandering mind, our rope is our mindfulness, firm post is the point where the breath touches, and wild animal is our mind. So we focus our mind, keeping this simile in mind, on the point where the breath touches. This is absolutely necessary for our meditation to gain a degree of concentration and insight. When you notice, focus the mind on the breath, the place where the breath touches. At first you notice the breath very rough, coarse. As you keep focusing mind on that point, breath slowly and slowly becomes subtler and subtler and subtler. It is just like when you ring a bell. You might have heard me ringing bell earlier. When we strike the bell with the stick, first you hear the coarse sound, hard sound, rough sound, and then it slowly fades away, making it softer and softer and softer. Similarly, the breath becomes softer and softer, and subtler and subtler. And then, at some point, mind, if you are not mindful, mind wanders here and there again, then you have to bring it back and keep it on the point where the breath touches. And then, gradually, mind becomes calm and calmer and calmer. And then, you notice the entire breathing process. That's called knowing the entire breath body. Breath body is just like another body. Breath is made up of elements, earth, air, water, fire, and therefore the breath is a body. And breath also is a body conditioner. It conditions our body by bringing oxygen into our lungs, recharging oxygen-depleted red blood cells, sending them to heart. Heart pumps throughout the body, recharging every cell in our body. That is how the breath conditions the body. Therefore, it is called body conditioner. In Pali, it is called Kaya Sankhara. And therefore, breath is when it becomes calm and calmer, softer and softer, we begin to notice internal respiration. And what is happening inside, we normally do not notice. But when the mind is calm, relaxed and peaceful, we feel the body becoming calm, relaxed and peaceful. And that is how we have tranquility of the body. This is called Pasamvayam, tranquilizing the body. Body tranquilizes through the tranquilizing the breath. The breath is calm, body is calm, and then the mind also becomes calm. When these three components of our personality are calm, relaxed, and peaceful, sometimes you may fall asleep. That also is very natural. You don't blame yourself for that. But you don't give in to sleepiness. You have to take care of it and overcome sleepiness by visualizing very bright light. You know, when you want to sleep, bright light doesn't help. You keep awake. Just like that, when you feel sleepy in meditation, visualize bright light, and that will help you to get rid of your sleepiness and drowsiness. When you get rid of your sleepiness and drowsiness, its opposite can happen. Mind is having worries, anxiety. It is vacillating between the past and the future, like a pendulum. So we have to take care of that by bringing the mind by force to the point where the breath touches again. Sometimes you may have greed when you have taken care of all this. Greed can arise in your mind. That also is very natural. You may remember a very delicious food, beautiful sight, very pleasant sound, taste, touch, and thoughts. They are very enticing, tempting, and we have to take care of them by realizing that they all are impermanent. You have tasted so many things, seen so many things. They all are gone. They all have been impermanent, are impermanent, will be impermanent. Therefore, we can get rid of them easily. And then resentment can arise. Resentment also should be taken care of by recalling our metta thoughts. At the beginning, we practice metta for this reason. During this 50 periods of more or better. But now, temporarily, for this meditation purpose, we just mention that we have to take care of anger by focusing mind on metta. Then when we have doubt, we have to have a great trust and confidence in the enlightenment of the Buddha. The faith and trust in his enlightenment, that he taught us the Dhamma, and following which many millions of individuals have attained liberation. We are following that path, and we can also reach that state if we very scrupulously continue his teaching, the practice. Keeping all these few instructions in mind, we spend few more minutes in silent meditation. Even though there are numerous things to say, but I restrain myself so that we all can have little time together, experiencing some peace through this meditation. And then at 10 o'clock we start our Dhamma talk. Sarai Nibbana Santi Pai. There is no concentration without wisdom, no wisdom without concentration. One who has both wisdom and concentration is close to peace and emancipation. Now, friends, we want to start our Dhamma talk on metta. I think this first feature in person, we hold this year, and we are so glad to see so many of you have come.